Hello, this is the ninth lesson of Everyday Sentences in Lithuanian series. Today's topic is orai, weather. This is the contents of our series, and please watch the introduction video if you hadn't already. And today is our ninth lesson. Let's start. Koks dabar oras Londone? Koks dabar oras Londone? What's the weather in London at the moment? Or now? Ar Londone dabar geras oras? Ar Londone dabar geras oras? Is the weather fine in London now? Ar šilta? Is it warm? Ar šalta? Is it cold? Kokia temperatūra Londone? Kokia temperatūra Londone? What's the temperature in London? Vakar buvo 25 laipsniai šilumos. Vakar buvo 25 laipsniai šilumos. Yesterday there were 25 degrees. This is degrees of warmth. Warmth, because šilumos is of warmth, so literally it means yesterday there were 25 degrees laipsnį of warmth or of heat, šilumos. So that means there were 25 plus 25 degrees. Next sentence: šiandien plus 30. Today it's plus 30. Šiandien plus 30. Next sentence. Rytoj Vilniuje bus 10 laipsnių šalčio. Rytoj Vilniuje bus 10 laipsnių šalčio. Just like in this sentence we had the word degrees of warmth, laipsnių šilumos, we have the word šalčio, laipsnių šalčio, of cold, of frost. Tomorrow there will be 10 degrees of frost in Vilnius. Laipsnių šalčio. 10 laipsnių šalčio, that means 10 degrees of frost or minus 10 degrees of Celsius. You see that 5 laipsnių here is nominative case and 10 laipsnių is genitive case. That's because of numbers, because with the number 10, from the number 10 to 19, with the exception of 11, genitive case is used, and with the words from 2 to 9, the nominative case is used. But I will explain it in some other video in the future. Next sentence. Poryt bus minus 20. Poryt bus minus 20. Day after tomorrow, there will be minus 20. Minus 20. We omit the word degrees. We say minus 20 and that's it. We omit the word degrees. And in this sentence also we omit the word degrees. We say plus 30. Minus 20. Plus 30, minus 20. We don't say the word degrees. Or we can say the word 25 degrees of heat, 25 laipsnių šilumos, or 10 degrees of frost, 10 laipsnių šalčio. Dabar lyja. It's raining now. Dabar smarkiai lyja. It's raining heavily now. Krapnoja. Krapnoja. It's sprinkling. Vakar buvo liūtis. Vakar buvo liūtis. Yesterday there was a downpour. Liūtis. The stress is after the word t. After the letter t. Liūtis. Vakar buvo liūtis. Next sentence. Šiandien sninga. Today it's snowing. Šiandien labai sninga. Today it's snowing heavily. Labai means a lot. Means very or a lot. Or in this context, heavily. Vakar labai daug prisnigo. Vakar labai daug prisnigo. Yesterday it snowed a lot of snow. Why did I write the word these words of snow? Because the emphasis is not that yesterday it snowed a lot, not on the action of snow, but on the results. The results that now there's a lot of snow everywhere. So the emphasis is on the result. You say prisnigo, it snowed a lot of snow. That means now there's a lot of snow. The prefix pri, sninga, it's now snowing, and snigo, it snowed, and prisnigo, it snowed a lot of snow. This is the perfective form of this verb, snigte, to snow. Prisnigo, it snowed a lot of snow. This is the emphasizing the results. This is the finished action with the prefix. Vakar labai daug prisnigo. Next sentence. Dabar slidūs keliai. Dabar slidūs keliai. Now the roads are slippery. Slidūs means slippery. Similar words in Lithuanian and in English. Next sentence. Yra plikledis. Yra plikledis. There's black ice. Black ice means that there's a thin ice layer on everywhere. On streets, on pavements, there's thin ice. Some ice. So, or it is called clear ice sometimes. So this means there's black ice or there's clear ice. And you can hear during weather forecasts, you could hear the words yra plikledis or bus plikledis. There will be black ice. That means that there will be or there is black ice. Next sentence. Ušalo upė. The river froze up. Ušalo jūra. The sea froze up. Jau tirpsta sniegas. The snow is already melting. Jau ištirpo sniegas. The snow has already melted. Yra rūkas. There's mist. Yra tirštas rūkas. There's thick mist. Naktį buvo šalna. Naktį buvo šalna. There was a frost at night. Šiandien apsiniaukė su pragiedruliais. Šiandien apsiniaukė. Or šiandien debesuota. Šiandien debesuota su pragiedruliais. That means today it's overcast or cloudy with bright periods. You will also hear this phrase debesuota su pragiedruliais. Šiandien or rytoj bus debesuota su pragiedruliais. That means cloudy with bright periods. And apsiniaukė, overcast. Not cloudy, but overcast. Just a little bit. And cloudy, when there's everywhere there are clouds. And su pragiedruliais. Pragiedruliai are bright periods. Šiandien apsiniaukė. Šiandien debesuota. Šiandien apsiniaukė su pragiedruliais. Šiandien debesuota su pragiedruliais. And one thing I have to say is that yra rūkas, this is such a declarative sentence. These are not used often. These are not used often. There's mist or there's thick mist. People don't say this often, but you will need the word rūkas, so I placed it in a sentence like this. This is a normal sentence, but mostly it's used with the past tense, perhaps, these such kind of sentences aren't used very much, but still usable. I'm talking only about the second sentence. Rytoj bus giedra. Rytoj bus giedra. Tomorrow there will be a fair weather. Fair weather, that means without a cloud or almost no clouds. Giedra. Giedra. Just like in all these other sentences with šalta, karšta, giedra, debesuota, these are šalta, karšta, giedra are adjectives of non-comparative degree. They are the adjectives of the neuter gender, not feminine, although feminine would be šalta, karšta, giedra, but this is the neuter gender, giedra, šalta, karšta. That means it is a fair weather, it is cold, it is hot, the neuter gender. So these are all adjectives of neuter gender, and apsiniaukę or debesuota are participles. Now let's get back to sentences. Next. Šią savaitę bus šalta. Šią savaitę bus šalta. This week there will be cold, or this week will be cold. Šią savaitę bus karšta. Šią savaitę bus karšta. Next. Praeitą savaitę buvo audra. Praeitą savaitę buvo audra. There was a storm last week. Praeitą savaitę means last week. Audra is a storm. Next. Pūtė stiprus vėjas. This is the past tense. Heavy wind blew. Pūtė stiprus vėjas. Pučia stiprus vėjas. Heavy wind is blowing, present tense. Pučia stiprus vėjas. And the future tense. Pūs stiprus vėjas. Heavy wind will blow. Pūs stiprus vėjas. Pūtė stiprus vėjas, pučia stiprus vėjas, and pūs stiprus vėjas. Smarkiai žaibuoja. It lightens heavily or a lot. Smarkiai. Smarkiai žaibuoja. It lightens. Smarkiai žaibavo. Smarkiai žaibavo. It lightened heavily or a lot. And the third. Smarkiai griausti. Smarkiai griausti. It is thundering heavily. Griausti is about the sound. The emphasis, this verb means the sound of thunder, to thunder, and žaibuoti means is about the light, of lightning. It lightens, it lightened, and it is thundering. Smarkiai griausti, it is thundering a lot. Next, rytoj pranešė lietų. Tomorrow a rain was forecasted. Rytoj pranešė lietų. Pranešė means informed, the past tense, and there is no subject. We don't know who informed, but we understand from the sentence. It's just like passive in English, but the third person in Lithuanian, the normal. The not passive, but the third person, while in English we translate it as passive, in the form of passive. So, rytoj pranešė lietų, a rain was forecasted, or tomorrow someone informed the rain, literally it means. But it means that the forecasters forecasted a rain. So, this is a good phrase to know. Rytoj pranešė, which means tomorrow something was forecasted. Rytoj pranešė. So, rytoj pranešė lietų, tomorrow a rain was forecasted. And the second sentence, rytoj pranešė šlapdriba. Rytoj pranešė šlapdriba. Tomorrow a sleet was forecasted. Or the translation is wrong a bit. I should have better translated, a rain or a sleet was forecasted for tomorrow. For tomorrow. It wasn't forecasted tomorrow, but it was forecasted for tomorrow. I hope you understood this. Next sentence. Ar žiūrėjai orų prognozę? Ar žiūrėjai orų prognozę? Did you watch the weather forecast? Prognozė is a forecast. Or, ar girdėjai orų prognozę? Ar girdėjai orų prognozę? Did you hear the weather forecast? Next. Ką pranešė? Ką pranešė? What did it say? Or literally, what did they inform the forecasters? We have the forecasters in mind. What did they inform? The word pranešti is shown in a vocabulary video with where all words with the same root, with the root neš or nash, are shown. This is one of the prefixed verbs of the root nesh. You can watch that vocabulary video. So this means, what did they inform, or what did the forecast say? This is the end of our 9th lesson about weather. The next lesson will be about feelings.